Yeah, so good morning all of you. So in last class we started carboxylic acid, fourth chapter of second year organic chemistry. Okay, so in this carboxylic acids already we completed ester hydrolysis. By the hydrolysis of the ester we can get the carboxylic acid. So based on the structure of the carboxylic ester molecule, that produce a carboxylic acid by different mechanism. Okay, that means the way of formation of the carboxylic acid that depends on the structure of the structure of the ester molecule. Already we gave naming for the ester hydrolysis of different compounds like AAC1, AAL1, like that. So that is one of the important topic for the advanced exam. So next, by acid halides and acid anhydrides, by the hydrolysis we will get the carboxylic acid. So hydrolysis of the acid halides and hydrolysis of the acid anhydrides, those reactions does not require any acid medium or basic medium because acid halides and acid anhydrides are more reactive. But in a case of the ester, that requires acid medium or basic medium. In case of the amide hydrolysis, that requires acid medium or basic medium because ester compound and amide compounds are less reactive when compared to acid halides and acid anhydrides. Okay, so in last class we have discussed that reactivity of the acid halides and that means acid derivatives. Okay, so now hydrolysis of the amides. So in this case here, the amides on a hydrolysis, any amide on a hydrolysis. But suppose here H2O in the presence of the acid medium, we will get the carboxylic acid plus NH4 plus. Okay, of course initially NH3 is produced, but NH3 is a basic in nature. So this reaction is carried out in the presence of the acid medium. That's why acid base reaction takes place between NH3 and H plus. We will get the NH4 plus and carboxylic acid. It is the acid medium hydrolysis. In case of the basic medium hydrolysis, H2O and basic medium hydrolysis, in this case RC double bond O minus and NH3. Okay, so your basic medium, so that base remove the proton from the carboxylic acid. That's why your only carboxylate ion is produced. In this case here, carboxylic acid and NH3, of course NH3 is a basic in nature that accept the H plus from the medium, so that is converted to NH4 plus. In this case here, carboxylic acid is produced that release the H plus ions to the OH minus that is present in the reaction mixture. So here carboxylic acid and carboxylate ion are the products in amide hydrolysis. Now the amides on hydrolysis produce carboxylic acid like, for suppose this is the cyclic amide, this one. Okay, the cyclic amide on a hydrolysis in acid medium, okay, that produce carboxylic acid and NH3 plus. Of course it is converted to NH2. Now here acid medium, so that NH2 converted to NH3 plus, because here that for suppose RNH2 in acid medium get protonated, so that is converted to NH3 plus. So like this here, in this case the reaction takes place, we will get this carboxylic acid. Okay, for suppose here this compound, this cyclic amide on reduction with lithium aluminum hydride, this compound on reduction with lithium aluminum hydride, we will get the amine only. Okay, the CO converted to CH. The amides on reduction with lithium aluminum hydride converted to amines. For suppose RC double bond O, this NH2 on reduction with lithium aluminum hydride, that is converted to RCH2 and NH2. Okay, that's it. So now here another reaction, this amide on reaction with HNO2, that means here NaNO2 and HCl, HNO2 is unstable, that's why at the time of reaction here we are adding NaNO2 and HCl. So NaNO2 HCl produce HNO2. So generally here this HNO2 in acid medium, okay, acid medium protonation takes place, loss of water molecule, that gives NO plus, the formation of the NO plus nitrosinium ion. You know that this one, you are very familiar with this reaction. Now here that NO plus electrophile attacks on the NH2. So in this case RC double bond O, this one NH2, okay, and this N double bond O, and this one carries a positive charge. Now here the loss of water molecule takes place. So here RC double bond O, it is converted to N2 plus, okay, it is converted to N2 plus. Okay, now here the loss of N2 plus, that produce RC double bond O plus, because here N2 is the excellent leaving group, that is leaving as N2 molecule, we will get the acyl carbocation, acyl carbocation. Now this molecule, this cation attacked by the water molecule. So here RC double bond O, here hydrogen, here hydrogen, in this case H. Okay, so put in, the water molecule attacks, and next step is loss of H plus, loss of H plus. So we'll get the RC double bond O, OH. That's it. Carboxylic acid. So it means here, like acid amides on hydroxys, we'll get the carboxylic acid. Okay, acid amides on reaction with HNO2 on the hydrolysis. Okay, of course, acid amides on hydrolysis produce carboxylic acid, and next step. Acid amide on reaction with HNO2 or NaNO2 HCl, that produce carboxylic acid through the acyl carbocation. Okay, this is the acylium ion, that is acylium ion. Okay, so that's it. For example, acid halide, this acid halide, this acid halide, on treating with aqueous AgNO3, aqueous AgNO3. So with aqueous AgNO3, actually with water, okay, with aqueous medium, acid halide converted to carboxylic acid, okay, and HCl. Now this HCl combines with the AgNO3, that gives AgCl white PPD. AgCl gives white PPD. So acid halides on reaction with the aqueous AgNO3 will get the carboxylic acid along with the AgCl white precipitate, and this amides on reaction with the HNO2 will get the carboxylic acid. Okay, so generally you know this reaction, the amines on reaction with the HNO2, what are the products? Alcohol is the product in the place of NH2, OH. Okay, so similarly that amides on reaction with the HNO2 will get the carboxylic acid. Okay, these are the one specific reactions, so mixed reactions. So generally you know this one, the amines on reaction with the HNO2 will get the alcohols. Okay, so write down this one. Okay, so next, see this one, the hydrolysis of the cyanides, hydrolysis of cyanides. So carboxylic, alkyl cyanide on hydrolysis produce carboxylic acid. If it is a complete hydrolysis, that is a carboxylic acid. Partial hydrolysis, that is amide. Okay. So generally here, from the alcohol we can get the cyanides. So alcohol on reaction with PCl3, PCl5, SOCl2 will get the alkyl halide. Okay. In the place of OH, we can see chlorine. Now here, this reaction on treating with the KCN, the Cl minus replaced by the CN minus. Okay, it is a nucleophilic substitution reaction, that SN2 type reaction. So this cyanide on a hydrolysis produce carboxylic acid. Okay, so you complete this reaction. And next, this carboxylic acid. So actually here, the alcohols on reaction with the PCl, the PCl will get the alkyl halide. Okay, but here carboxylic acid on reaction with SOCl2, PCl3, PCl5 will get the acid halides. Okay, these reagents on reaction with alcohol will get the alkyl halide. So here the same reagents and reaction with the amide, SOCl2, PCl3, PCl2 or P2O5, acid amides, okay, we will get the cyanides. Here dehydration takes place. Okay, here carboxylic acid and NH2, sorry, here oxygen and H2, here dehydration takes place, cyanides are produced. So very, very important reaction. Acid amides on reaction with SOCl2, PCl3, PCl5, S and P2O5, it is also dehydrating agent. In this case, removal of the water molecule takes place, will get the cyanides. Okay, just now we discussed the amides on reaction with HNO2, carboxylic acids are the products. Okay, na? Carboxylic acid and these reagents will get the acid halide. Amide and these reagents will get the cyanides. Okay, and next here, we can complete this reaction also. Now here, the next from diethyl malonate, it is a malonic acid actually, okay, an oxalic acid, malonic acid, glutaric acid, adipic acid, pimelic acid, you know that one. So next here, malonic acid, its ester is a diethyl malonate, okay, generally its ester is a calling as a malonate, here ethyl gives a, so diethyl malonate. So this diethyl malonate on a hydrolysis will get the dicarboxylic acid. This dicarboxylic acid on a heating will get the acid. So here decarboxylation takes place. Okay? Dicarboxylic acid on heating, decarboxylation takes place. That's it. Now for suppose some another one application of this diethyl malonate. This diethyl malonate, this two ester groups are the electron withdrawing groups. So hydrogens on this carbon are acidic in nature. So on treating with the NaOET base, that ETO minus base remove the H plus from this carbon. So we'll get the carbanion. This carbanion acting as nucleophile. So on adding ethyl chloride, nucleophile substitution takes place. So here CH minus bonding with this carbon. That means here CH3CH2 and then CHCOOET twice. Okay. So now this ester, diester hydrolysis produces dicarboxylic acid. This dicarboxylic acid under heating, loss of CO2 takes place. Okay. So we'll get the CH3CH2CH2COOH. Betanoic acid is the product. Okay. So that is the cyanide hydrolysis and preparation of the carboxylic acid from the diethyl malonate. Okay, so generally in this reaction, amides on treating with PCl5, PCl3, SOCl2, P2O5 will get the cyanides. Okay, carboxylic acid on treating with SOCl2, PCl3, PCl5, acid halides are the products. Now here, the carboxylic acids, okay, for suppose the carboxylic acid on heating with P2O5, their dehydration takes place by combination of the two molecules. Okay, in this case here, within the molecule dehydration takes place. The two hydrogens and oxygen dehydration. In this case, by combination of the two molecules, dehydration takes place. P2O5 is a dehydrating agent. So we will get the acid anhydride. Okay. These are the side reactions. And these are the correlated reactions we can remember strictly. Okay. So write down. Okay. Next, one more reaction. You know this one. Grignard reagent, RMgCl, on reaction with the CO2 followed by hydrolysis, we will get the carboxylic acid. Okay? Because in this case, this R minus attacks on this carbon. So we will get the RC double bond O minus. And this one on a hydrolysis, we will get the carboxylic acid. It is the carbonation of the Grignard reagents. Okay? So write this example. CH3. NBS H nu. Second one, magnesium tetrahydrofuran, third one CO2 and fourth one hydrolysis. Okay, write the product. Just here, Grignard reagent on reaction CO2 followed by hydrolysis, we will get the carboxylic acids. Okay, so it is from the carboxylic acid, from the Grignard reagent. Okay, for suppose here, the alkyl lithium on reaction CO2. Okay, alkyl lithium on reaction CO2. So write the product. Okay, in this case carboxylic acid is not produced. Okay, next. Next, one more another method, that is oxidation of alkyl benzene. Oxidation of alkyl benzene. That means here, this is the alkyl benzene. Okay, alkyl benzene. That means here benzene derivative. It is a substituted benzene. Not only alkyl group, it is a substituted benzene. This compound on oxidation with alkaline KMnO4 or acidified KMnO4 or acidified potassium dichromate or H2CrO4, okay, or HNO3, okay, concentrated HNO. So here this alkyl, that means the substituted benzene, on treating with this oxidizing agents, all these are the strong oxidizing agents. So here that group is converted to simply carboxylic acid. Okay, that means here that R may be methyl or ethyl or isopropyl or N-propyl, whatever it is. Okay, that group is simply converted to carboxylic acid. R CH double bond CH2 or C triple bond CH or CH2OH or CHO or CO CH3, whatever it is, converted to simply carboxylic acid. That means here in this case toluene or ethyl benzene, toluene or ethyl benzene or any alkyl group, okay, any N-alkyl group or isopropyl benzene is nothing but cumene, on treating with KMnO4, acidified potassium dichromate, okay, hot acidified potassium dichromate, this simply converted to carboxylic acid. Okay, any compound can give the carboxylic acid, that's it. Okay, that means here for suppose the C triple bond CH or CH double bond CH2 or CHO and CH2OH, this one also on oxidation with these reagents simply converted to carboxylic acid. Okay, so no doubt here, just carboxylic acid is a simple product. Whatever the reactant, okay, whatever the reactant, then the alkyl benzene or derivative, so simply converted to carboxylic acid. Okay, for suppose this one contains two groups, okay, here KMnO4, acidified KMnO4, hot acidified KMnO4, here simply converted to carboxylic acid, is a dicarboxylic acid. Okay, it is a terephthalic acid. Terephthalic acid is the product. Okay, for suppose here CH3 and this one CH double bond CH2. Again here this compound also converted to dicarboxylic acid, COOH and COOH. This is isothiolic acid. This is isothiolic acid. For suppose this one CH3 and this one CH3. Orthoxylene. This is orthoxylene. This orthoxylene on oxidation, acidified potassium permanganate. Okay, so it is converted to C double bond OH and C double bond OH. Okay, and this one is a tolic acid. Phthalic acid. And here, this one on further heating, okay, this one on further heating, just here loss of water molecule takes place. So here, that gives C double bond O, oxygen, C double bond. That means here, this is the phthalic anhydride. Okay, this is phthalic anhydride. But in this case here, terephthalic acid on heating, no anhydride formation because these two groups are not adjacent to each other. Now here, this isophthalic acid on further heating, no anhydride formation because these two groups far away from each other. Now here, these two groups are adjacent to each other. So by heating, the cyclization takes place with loss of water molecule. So that produces the phthalic anhydride. Okay, it's very, very important. Just here, 1,2 substituted derivative on oxidation followed by heating gives an anhydride. Okay, on oxidation followed by heating gives anhydride molecule. Okay, so whatever the molecule, for suppose the CH3 and for suppose C double bond OH is aldehyde molecule, it is aldehyde group, or you can take whatever it is CH2OH. So on treating with acidified KMnO4, acidified KMnO4, first that produce carboxylic acid, that means phthalic acid, and this one further heating produce phthalic anhydride, okay, that is the product of this reaction. Okay, it is oxidation of the benzene derivative with the KMnO4. Okay. Write down this one. Okay. Now here you see very interesting reaction. In this case, there is a one exceptional reaction. If the alkyl group is tertiary butane, okay, if the alkyl group is tertiary butane, that means it is a tertiary butyl benzene. So your KMnO4 acid medium, no reaction. Okay, KMnO, acidified potassium permanganate, in this case here no reaction. Okay. Whenever the tertiary butyl group is attached to the benzene, that alkyl group is not oxidized. Okay, and now next CH3, if this one is a NO2 or SO3H, okay, NO2, SO3H or like COOH, that means see, these groups are not affected by the acidified potassium dichromate. Okay, so like NO2, SO3H, Cl or COOH, this one on oxidation with acidified potassium permanganate, these groups are not affected. Just this alkyl group is converted to carboxylic acid. Okay, that means NO2, SO3H, Cl and COOH. Okay, these groups are not affected. Okay, and next. But suppose, that means it is a CHO and it is a tertiary butyl. This one on oxidation, KMnO4H+. Okay, just a CHO group is converted to COOH, but not tertiary butyl group. Okay, and this benzene contains this cyclic ring. Okay, so this one also converted to carboxylic acid, COOH. Okay, carboxylic acid is the product. Okay, next one more reaction. This is the compound. So this one on oxidation gives simply carboxylic acid. Okay, that is on oxidation gives simply carboxylic acid. Okay, now for suppose this OH on oxidation, actually it is a tertiary carbon, so this alkyl group is not oxidized, but here there is an alcohol group, so that is oxidized to ketone. Okay, interesting example. That is, this alcohol is just oxidized. Here in this case there is a CH2, it's not a tertiary carbon, so totally that that alkyl group is converted to carboxylic acid. Okay, that's it. And now for suppose this is the compound, this one on oxidation, the same reagent. Okay, so actually here this is the CH2 and this is the CH2. For suppose generally here if it is a diethyl, dimethyl CH2 CS, that means CS is CS3, this compound on oxidation gives a dicarboxylic acid. This compound on oxidation gives a dicarboxylic acid. Now here this compound on oxidation gives again dicarboxylic acid. C double bond O, OH, and C double bond O. Okay, that means here these two groups also oxidize. Of course here these carbons are converted into carbon dioxide like CO2. Okay, here this cyclic ring is also converted to dicarboxylic acid. But here in this case the monocyclic ring, the cyclic ring attached through the one bond. Okay, it is a fused compound, it is a two it is also bicyclic compound, it is a bicyclic compound, it is a fused bicyclic compound, it is not a fused bicyclic compound, just it is isolated bicyclic compound. So this is totally converted to COOH, but in this case here two carbons are attached to the benzene, so that is the product. Okay, for suppose the 5 membered ring, there is a methane, so this one on oxidation gives tricarboxylic acid, COOH and COOH, this one also COOH. Okay, so that is the product of this reaction. Okay, next one more example. For example here this compound, this one on oxidation gives a dicarboxylic acid. A breaking of this one, okay, breaking the double bond, COOH, here also COOH. Okay, that is the product of this reaction. Or suppose pH CH2 pH, so this is the case on oxidation, so gives a PHC double bond O pH. In this case here no breaking. For suppose pH CH2 pH on oxidation, here breaking takes place, so here pH COOH, two moles of the carboxylic acid, 2 moles of the carboxylic acid.